Hi guys! If you're considering designing and then printing t-shirts for business, for an event such as a birthday or even a wedding, or just for personal use, then this video is for you. You might be thinking about building an extra stream of revenue by starting a print-on-demand business. If so, then you definitely need to watch this video because I'm going to show you how easy it is, even for a non-designer, to create a beautiful t-shirt using Canva. I know some entrepreneurs make hundreds, if not thousands of dollars a month designing printables in Canva and then selling their products online. I'll go through the entire process with you, starting from finding a suitable template in Canva. I'll show you how to find some really handy print tools in Canva which you may not even know existed, which will make the difference between a slightly amateurish design and a pro design. And then when you've finished designing, I'll show you two ways to send your design to print. And if you use Canva's own print services, your t-shirt will arrive in this really sweet little bag right here. Do stay tuned until the end of the video because I'm going to share some very important legal information which will help you keep on the right side of copyright law. I can't wait to get started, so let's dive in. You can find all the templates you need from your Canva homepage by going up to the top left-hand corner of your screen, selecting Features and then Print Products. Now scroll down until you find the T-shirt's thumbnail image and click on it. So now you've landed on the Custom T-shirts page in Canva, where you'll find all the information you need as well as some frequently asked questions. I'll leave you to explore all of this because I'm going to go back to my homepage to show you how to search for a suitable template. I like to use the search bar to find exactly what I'm looking for quickly. So I'm just going to type in t-shirt. And as you can see, Canva has made some suggestions for me based on various categories. I'm just going to click on t-shirt. And you'll see Canva brings up hundreds of potential templates that you can use. So scroll down and have a look. If you see a little icon like this with a crown next to it, it means that it's a Canva Pro template. But since I'm a Canva Pro holder, it is free to me. If you've not experienced Canva Pro yet, you can take it for a free test ride for an exclusive 45 days at no extra expense to yourself using my Canva partner link. I'll leave it in the description box below. Scrolling back up to the top, you'll find some handy filters on the left-hand side of your screen. So you can use these filters to narrow down your search according to style, theme, and even color. You can preview a template before opening it up by hovering your mouse over the template thumbnail and clicking on these three little dots. Now click on Preview this template. So this opens up a new window where you can view the template more closely. You can also find some more designs underneath, which are either similar in style or designed by the same creator. If you like what you see, you can go ahead and customize this template by clicking on this button here, and that will bring it up onto your Canva desktop. I'm actually going to close this down because what I want to do is create a blank t-shirt. So now I have a lovely blank t-shirt template on my desktop. Don't worry, because you can still get inspiration and help from the left-hand side column by checking out all the categories of t-shirt. If you want to explore a category further, just click on the heading or click on See All. And Canva will bring up all the templates associated with that category. But what I want to do is to create a t-shirt for a friend of mine who runs a boarding lodge for parrots, would you believe? It's absolutely true. So I'm going to go to the left-hand side toolbar. I'm going to select Elements. Then I'm going to find Graphics. And I'm going to use the search bar to search for parrots. And Canva will bring up every single graphic of a parrot it can find. What I want to do now is narrow down my search even further using this really handy search tool, which I'm going to click on, and I'm going to select all the graphics which are free. So I'm just going to put a little tick in this box next to free, apply filters, and here are all the free graphics. I think I'm going to use this chap, so I'm going to click on him to add him to my template. I'm going to resize and reposition him. Now, at some stage, you might want to know what your t-shirt is looking like and whereabouts on the t-shirt your graphics and text appears. So to do that, you go to the top right-hand corner of your Canva toolbar and click on Print T-shirts. And underneath, you have a really handy mock-up of a t-shirt with your design over it. And you can see my little parrot is in the top left-hand corner of my t-shirt. If I move my parrot around on the template, you can see what happens on the mock-up. Now I'm going to add a little bit of text to my design before I print it. So I'm going to go to the Text tab. And I'm going to go ahead and add my text. Fabulous. Now, if you want to create truly professional designs, particularly if you want to sell them, you want to learn how to use a couple of Canva's little hidden tools. So go to the top left-hand side of your toolbar in Canva and click on the File tab. And right at the top, you have some little print tools. So I'm going to click on Show Rulers. And now you can see I have a ruler on the far left-hand side of my template and also right at the top. I'm going to click on File again and click on Show Margins. And now you can see I have a margin inside my template. Now I'm going to use both the rulers and the internal margin to help me line up all my elements in the template. So first of all, I'm going to right align the text. Next, I'm going to use the ruler to help me add another margin to my template. So if I hover my mouse over the ruler on the left-hand side, you'll see that it turns to a double-sided arrow. Now hold your cursor down and drag it right across your template. And I'm going to drag it to the far right-hand side of my little parrot. Perfect. And now I'm going to make sure that my text is lined up exactly with this ruler line. Wonderful. So everything now, all my elements in the template are perfectly aligned. To remove the ruler line, all I need to do is hold my cursor over it again and drag it off my template. Once you've finished your designs and you've made any final adjustments and you're ready to print off your design, you can do one of two things. You can download your design as it is by going to the download button, select your file type as PDF print. You might want to consider adding crop marks and bleed, so put a tick in this box here, and then download your design. Of course, if you want a really streamlined process, you can use Canva's own printing services. To do that, go back to the Print T-shirts button and click on it. Underneath, decide whether you want your design to be printed on one side or both sides of your t-shirt. If you have multiple pages in your design, decide which page you want to print. Select your t-shirt colour. Select the style, so decide whether you want a t-shirt for men, women, youths, toddlers or infants. I'm going to stick with women. Select how many t-shirts you want printing. Select your size. Underneath you have a really handy subtotal. Click on continue to go to the next screen. And here you'll be prompted to add some shipping details. So you can select whether you want standard delivery or express delivery. And Canva is telling me there is a slight delay on delivery due to COVID. Type in your name, address and phone number. Click on continue. And before you actually confirm your order, you might want to add any coupon codes that you have. If so, just enter them in this box here. And once you're done, click on place order. Now, I mentioned at the start of this video that there was some very important legal information that you need to read before you start printing and selling your designs using Canva. This information is particularly important if you intend to design and sell templates using Canva. I would highly recommend that you read all the information that I've left for you by clicking the links in the description box underneath this video. I really don't want to see you getting on the wrong side of copyright law. It could be a very costly and stressful mistake for you. In the meantime, whilst you're waiting for my next video, why not check out Canva's new video editor? It's absolutely amazing. And whilst you're there, check out how to add some text overlay to your videos and then add some super professional and eye-catching animations to it. You'll find the links for these videos just here. Thank you so much for watching and for all your support, and I will see you next time.